I'm Chef Pedro Alaniz. I'm a celebrity chef, TV host, restaurateur, traveler, writer, producer, director, and food lover. I'm gonna tell you about my story, how I came to the United States. I came here in 1985 under the Reagan administration when they had the amnesty back in 85. I came here by myself. I didn't have anybody. I crossed the border and I ended up living in Encinitas, California, in the hills, the mountains, for 3 months. I stationed there and I work in agriculture. I work in construction. I work as a landscaper. And I did many, many other jobs. After 3 months, I found out that I had my uncle, Darío Alaniz. And I found his phone number and I gave him a call and he helped me out to move from Encinitas, California to Monterey, California. While living in there, I found myself working in the fields in Salinas, California, picking up lettuce, strawberries. But I didn't like that job because it was too hot. So I applied in restaurants and I found myself working in a restaurant after a few months. My first job was the La Chapelle Beach as a dishwasher for 3 months. I worked in the nighttime cleaner. I cleaned kitchens and then I was promoted to a cook. I worked for Pebble Beach for 7 years and I got trained in all the stations, salads, pastry, head cook. In 1993, I moved to Florida my first job as a pastry chef at Ocean Reef Club, upscale club in Key Largo. I started working there and I've been working in private clubs since then. But let me go back. In the 1990s, I started helping my brothers and my family come in here. I helped 7 brothers. Two of them are lawyers. One is in Mexico, one is here in Virginia. My brother lawyer wanted to join the army to pay for his college debt. He did, he joined the army. He went to Afghanistan and fought 3 years. Up there, he came back. He took some time off, took a year off, and now he's just enjoying life. He's happy to be back, and we're happy that he's back. Unfortunately, my brother is not what he used to be. War changes people, but he served his country. After all, that's what it's all about here, the United States, serving your country. During the time that I brought my family and I sent them to school for the last, my youngest brother was 6 years old. Right now, he's 20 years old. When he became 18 years old, I told him that he had to go on his own because, you know, life is hard, and he chose to go on his own and do his life, but he couldn't go to school because he didn't have a green card. Remember, they came here, I brought him here, and they had no legal status. Three of my brothers became legal through the 2000, there was a program where you work for somebody and they pretty much ask you to get your green card, or I don't know what the process was, but they became legal. Four of my brothers currently don't have legal status, and that's why I'm here. I'm asking you members of Congress, House of Representatives, Senate, President, we must pass this immigration reform. There is 11 million people right now that they need a legal status. To become a citizen, I have to go through a process of studying and learn the history. And I learned that in 1850 to 1950, 11 million people walked through the Ellis Island, New York, and they got their citizenship. As a matter of fact, 40% of you members of Congress probably have a descendant that came through the island. This is the time. This is the time to pass a comprehensive immigration reform. The United States is about family. It's about values. It's about family reunion. And There is people that have been separated. There is kids that have been left alone here. And this is not what America's about. I love this country. My family fought for this country. They deserve a chance to be here.